Let's do the ClO3 minus Lewis structure. Chlorine has 7 valence electrons plus 6 for oxygen times 3, and this up here means we have another valence electron for a total of 26 valence electrons. Chlorine is the least electronegative. That goes in the center. Oxygen's around it. 2 valence electrons to form chemical bonds between the atoms. We've used 6, then around the outside atoms, 8, 10, 24. We have 2 left over there. We'll put them down here to complete the octet for chlorine. So we've used all 26 valence electrons, and each of the atoms now has an octet. So it looks pretty good, except chlorine is in period 3 of the periodic table. That means that it can often hold more than 8 valence electrons, so we need to check our formal charges. Turns out our formal charges show that we have a plus 2 formal charge on the chlorine, and that the oxygens each have a minus 1 formal charge. If you add that all up, it does give you this minus charge right here, which makes sense. But the closer the formal charges are to 0, the better the structure is. So let's take a look and see how we can fix this. If I take these valence electrons right here and move them into the center for 2 oxygens, that should take care of this plus 2 charge. So let's see what that does to our formal charges now that we've moved those in there to form a double bond. So by making those double bonds between this oxygen and chlorine and then this one here, we now have a formal charge of 0 on the chlorine and on these 2 oxygens right here. Well, this oxygen, the black one, has a negative 1 charge. And that makes sense because the total charge here, now negative 1, and this is negative 1 as well. One last thing, since it is an ion, we do need to put brackets around it to show that it is an ion and it has a negative charge. And that represents the best Lewis structure for ClO3-. I'm Dr. B, and thanks for watching.